Hello everyone, I'm going to work on my geode again, and I've decided that the glitter line I put on doesn't fit with the rest, so I'm pouring another glitter line on top of it, the turquoise one, and it's a mixed glitter, so a large glitter and fine glitter together, and I'm trying to cover up as much as I can. And also, I have decided that it needs a highlight in some areas. So I'm going to also add some lighter colors. But first, the glitter line. So I pour the line on top of the rose gold dark blue one. And now with my stirring stick, I'm pushing it where I want it. And I hope that will look a little bit better. And also all the materials I'm using are again in the beginning of this video, but also in the description box with the links where I buy them. If you want to see, then you can go to the description box. And there you will find where I buy my my glitters and all the rest of the materials. And I also find that the gold that I added, the pale gold, also makes it a little bit dark. So I'm going to cover that a little bit with a lighter color. And I'm getting very excited if the molding dough will come off, because I'm almost done with this geode, and then I can unmold it. So yeah. I'm also thinking about another silicone spray, because I now use the WD-40, and we all know that's not good for your health. So I have thought about another silicone, and that's safe, so I want to test that also. And now I'm pouring some clear on the outside, and I cleaned it first, because there were a lot of glitter, loose glitter on top of the geode. So I cleaned it first with a brush and also with some alcohol, because otherwise I have glitter everywhere and I don't like that. And I also want to cover the mica flakes totally under the clear, because if I want to make a table of it, then it needs to have a flat surface. So yeah, it's going to have some more layers to get it all flat. And now with my stirring stick, I push the resin against the outer barrier and also against the mica flakes. Yeah, and now I'm adding a lighter color, and it's the African Sky of Color Art. Very nice light blue color, and it has a green sheen over it. So it fits very well with the green I already have in my geode, the aqua color. And I'm pushing it against my glitter line I just put on. Very gently I do that, very carefully. Yeah, and I already like it much better than with the other glitter line, so this looks already okay. And against the African sky, I'm pouring a line of stone coat white base tint, because I want to use the swipe technique again, because I want to have some nice effects on top of the Belize blues and the transparent violet. not much, but I want to create a little bit more depth. And against the stone coat white, I'm pouring some glare resin, because then it can flow into that, and then it will lay on top of all the other layers. More clear. Also a little bit of heat to make it a little bit more liquid so that it can flow to the sides. And I'm starting with the first swipe. So I'm trying to drag the African sky over the stone coat white into the clear so that it lays on top of the Belize blues and the transparent violet. And I'm using Yupo paper again, because I like a thick paper for swiping. I think you get a better result if the paper is a little bit thicker. And different sizes of swipe paper, what I always do. But I need to watch out, because I don't want to have these colors on top of the mica flakes. A little bit of heat to see what effects I'm getting. So I place my Yupo paper against the glitter line and I drag the African sky over the stone coat white into the clear. And then it lays on top of the other colors. I'm adding a little bit more African sky. And then I do the swipe again. There you can see it. And if the glitter line spreads a little bit, I don't mind. I like that. It doesn't have to be a straight line. And all the way around, I'm going to swipe these colors. A little bit of heat, not too much, because then you lose all your effects. again a little bit more African sky. Such a nice color. Little bit more clear where I don't have any resin, also over the mica flakes. Also the torch for the air bubbles. Some clear on top of my fire glass and the glow in the dark stones. I already tested those stones and they look very nice in the dark. They have an aquamarine color. But I'm at the end, if I have it out of the mold, I will also try to make a video of that so you can see that also. A little bit more African sky on that side. And again, I'm going to swipe. And some heat again. Not too much. And I like the effects I'm getting. So I'm almost done with this first part, and then we can go to the second part of this video, and that will be a clear coat. So I'm going to show you also how I apply a clear coat. So I begin around my fire glass. It dried very well, so this is after 24 hours. And I'm liking the effects I have of the African sky, and it gives a much brighter look to it, so I'm very pleased how it looks. Normally I don't show the clear coat, but I think you need to see how I do that. So I begin at the inside and I'm working my way to the outside. Also some heat to make it more liquid, so that it will flow to the sides. And now I'm adding more resin to the outside because I want to cover all my mica flakes. It needs to be flat. And yeah, when it's out of the mold, I will give it another clear coat. Again, some heat. More clear because against the outer barrier I don't have enough, so I'm adding more because I look at it in all directions and then I can see where I missed a spot where it needs more clear resin. And again a little bit of heat. More clear over my glitter line. And the fire glass. Yeah, it's not that interesting to see me adding a clear coat, but yeah, it's also part of the process and I want to show you all the whole process, how I make my geodes. So this is also a part of it. So the torch for the air bubbles. I do this several times, you know that already, but yeah, I'm gonna tell you anyway. More clear on top of my mica flake because they need to be all on under the resin. So yeah, that's why I'm adding it. So I'm adding the last bit of clear I have left. And again the torch for the air bubbles. I do this several times, also during my drying process in the first hour. I'll go back and check if there are new air bubbles. And I will remove them with the torch again. Because it's not nice if there are air bubbles in it, or dust, or whatever. Yeah, I'm almost done with this layer. And then we can go to the close-up. So this is how it looks after several hours of drying, and I like it much better than I had before. The color I added and also the effects, yeah, gives it a whole nother look. It's much brighter, I like that, and also the glitter I added, the turquoise color, the mixed glitter, I like it very much. There you can see the effects. It's lying on top of the Belize Blues and transparent violet. So it has a lot of depth. I like it. And also structure. The mica flakes look great with the holographic glitter mix in it. So I'm very happy how this geode looks. Yeah, and the next step will be to take it out of the mold. So I'm getting already excited if that works. And yeah, we will see. A little bit closer. I still have some gold in it. Not too much, but a little bit. It has a, yeah, it gives a nice accent and contrast with the other colors. There you can see the African sky and also the transparent violet and the mica flakes. Also the turquoise glitter line with the mixed glitter sizes. So I like that. There you can see that it has also a green shine over it. Also there the contrast color in the transparent violet, the blue-purple of Color Obsession. And also the green glitter line against my fire glass, very nice. The different shades of aqua. There you see the gold, the pale gold of Just Resin. Very nice, and also the sparkle pearl. Yeah, I'm very pleased with this geode. So I'm hoping it will come out easy. But yeah, if it doesn't, then I have a little bit more work. Also, there are the effects in the African sky. So the next step will take it out of the mold, sand the sides because I have a sharp edge on the top layer, so I need to sand that, and then I will give it a clear coat, and then it's all done. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. Give me a thumbs up for this video if you like what I'm doing. If you have comments, tips or questions, place them under the video or send me an email. You can also find me on Facebook and Instagram. All the links you want to know are in the description box. So check that out. And I will all see you in the next video. Bye!